this album will be too much for this stream, but that's okay. Anyway, slow start today. But oh well. I am an hour late as well, even though today is a big stream because we are going to be doing the fabled events for the medium. Or at the very least, we're going to implement one of them. And then the system to support it. But okay, welcome back. See, I've talked about before. What do I have here? Oh yeah. I want to make a procedural thing where I make a billion games. But that's a little outside the scope of this video game, though. Let's see, so that is somewhere in here. Yeah, so don't steal my cool idea. But okay, so I've talked before. The medium has layers, the medium has modifiers. Moms are like onions. So what we're gonna do is the event system. Let's talk about the event system. In fact, let's talk specifically about the event that I'm gonna be making today, because I've been making a side quest where a person who knew Jackie's mom as a kid tells you what little he knows about her, because he only, like, saw her or her family. He didn't, like, he wasn't, like, a close friend. And then he takes you to the city, and you can talk about the people who used to live here, and stuff like that. And eventually the city will look cooler as well. But what we're going to do today is I want to make an event in the medium where it creates a whole new room, and you can talk to, basically, a specific version of Jackie's mom based on what he tells you, which is basically that she got shot and died in the war. But apparently not, because she's alive. Let's see, and I think my Twitch is off. There we go. But okay. Oh. I want to manage that volume a little bit. But okay, let's get into it. So I think the plan is going to be for this specific event. Let's reread this story. So where even is this? Okay. The shopkeeper tells you of the Tara he knew as a boy. She was a few years younger than him, which would have made her about 56 today, or 29 when you were born. This matches your mother's age. They grew up in the city surrounding the tree tower, Sherrod. When the war with Valen broke out, the areas between the tree, or the areas around the tree tower, including, oh, what was I trying to say here? Tower and Sherrod were. Let's see. Were a crucial stronghold. When Valers laid siege to the city, I'm gonna say when the Valers laid siege to the city, Tara's parents were killed. She tried to attack a soldier with a knife, but was shot and collapsed. She was 16 years old. That was the last he ever saw her before he and his family fled the city. Okay, so this is our little anecdote. So basically, I think there's going to be a few things that I want to have. One is, you can just, once you've heard his anecdote, you don't actually have to go to this city. So you could just go back to the medium. But then if you haven't seen it, clearly it should be different. So what I'm going to do is, room. Let's have, like, So there's gonna be, I think, maybe just two variations of the room broadly, and then, like, more specific details as I think of them. Red Brick Gary. See it. And then it's going to be like. Oh, wait, I know. You've seen the outside of the city. This could actually be quite complicated to make, but I want to make it. Basically, the ability to have scenes larger. Then the medium, so if we go to the illusory room, this is where all of these take place. So, like, let's, like, do, like, a deactivate. So, you know, a cool little thing. So what I want is now, for some, well... Yeah, I'll figure out how to do that. I do have a stencil buffer. Keep the tree still standing. Basically, correct walls and things. Scene B. And if you've seen apartments in the city, and a specific So then, if we go to the one apartment in the entire game that currently exists, it would be... Hang on, where is it? It would be like this, but not dingy. So I have to make another texture for this, but it'll be easier. And it'll even have sheets and blankets and stuff. That makes sense. Okay, and then other details as I think of them. Okay, and then we need some important things, which are her appearance. Because there's basically going to be a teenage version. So how would she... I need to figure out how humans actually dress, because we have the funny little guys. And I guess I could just use... basically the same as her, like, default appearance, quote-unquote, without the spooky, creepypasta face, because for some reason, every single time I re-import a GLTF in Godot, it removes the textures that I've added, or the materials. Even though it's here. This is a property of the node, it's not a property of the mesh. This is the property of the mesh. But Godot's just too good for that. Needs to forget every single time. Okay. So let's say... Depending on Horstog. And I think the big thing that'll mean is I don't think they have head wrappings. That's Sirdi. Actually, I wonder where that would be understood. Oh wait, this, I was like, what the fuck is this? This little guy. I was like, what is this scary little turkey? But okay. So I think I should have probably put this in the to-do list rather than here. Let's do the event. So we'll have, well, we already have the generic red brick, so let's do generic, hand brick. And then, like, apartment. Because I think Jackie would assume by default that she was Muslim and therefore had like the head wrap. Well, actually, would she know about, because even in Muslim countries before like fundamentalists took over, they typically didn't require like head wrappings or head coverings. And that's exactly what happened in the country of Yakaz. So I think maybe it would be instead head wrap or not. Well, I guess it would be Muslim, Bree Emirate. So, like, basically, Norstad Toxin. Or I guess learned. I don't know what this is gonna be, but it's gonna be in here. So let's do medium. Event 01. Norstad War. I guess that gives us the stuff that I need to start on that. But first in our daily, so that was planning this, so let's fix a bug though. While I think on that. Okay. Let's do more movement stuff. Oh, this one was fixed. That was basically the climbing was jank. Let's make sure that the water stuff works. Because I think there are some of these that I fixed impulsively, like off stream without actually checking the to-do list. Also, Derek, I should have remembered to put the, in the devlog B-roll, there was a bug where if you slept, you would then wake up and fall through the ground before the world actually loaded. Oh wait, let's teleport. Where is water? Video game taking a while to activate here. And eventually the grass needs to be more graceful with its like colors and stuff. Let's see, is this, I think I could, it's so much smaller, hang on. Okay, now, why is it so much smaller, hang on. Let's go to the jump. Oh, wait, I know. Huh. I don't get it. Okay, state data, waiting, jump. Burst is 5. So what is the burst of a standard jump? Burst is 8. I guess let's try just 7 or something. And unfortunately, with the way I set this up, I have to restart the game whenever I alter these. Take your time, Godot. Jeez. A little janky because of the way the air fall or the water falling in that work. Admittedly, you know what? That was so easy. I'm gonna fix a second bug. Because I think this one might be the one I fixed. No, it's not. Okay. Hang on. Where is waiting? Oh, wait. Function next state. Waiting depth. So if water green. Okay. So what we should do is. If we're crouching. If we can climb. We should do. Alright, let's do this. Hover, hover state, hover. Hmm. If can climb, blah blah blah. Wait, I know. Let's do if not waiting. And roll input and blah 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 and this and that. And I think these two, I think these ones are honestly okay. This one is where we actually put this now. Because it should just be that we don't roll when we're in water. And then what I'll do here is... Do we have climb? We do have climb here as well. So if we have this, if roll input, but not waiting. Oh, wait, no. If waiting depth. Oh. Wait, hang on. Do I use waiting depth wrong here? If water depth less than or equal to waiting depth. Okay, so this is an elif. So yeah, we climb here, and then... I guess, honestly, we should just have, like, a in-water or something like that. I'll just do that. Elif in water. And then we'll do that for here. So admittedly, a little bit more duplicated code, but that's okay. Not quite correct. Hang on. What does this mean? So we're not sliding, actually. So if we're crouching, we're not crouching either. Oh, wait, it's because state up. I'm waiting. Did I do that wrong for all of these? I did. Oh, wait, no, this one I think is correct. Yeah, because this is when we're sliding. Right. So, okay, that was my malfunction. That's what I get for copy and pasting. Okay, so let's try climbing up this. So this doesn't quite work, and we see some jank here, but I'll say that's a... Well, is that a separate bug? Hang on. Does that work if I did a similar thing like here? No, this is a different bug though. You know what? Hang on. Get free call. Or let's do globe. No. Call group. Yeah, go away. We're fixing things over here. All right, so let's see what states we're going into. So we're waiting, climbing, clinging, falling, etc. So why does this? I see. There's something weird with. So basically, if I hold forward. Well, wait. Hang on. Now it's just. Now it can just work sometimes. Man, we need to print. We need our print statement back. Okay, so what are we going into? We go from waiting to climbing, climbing to waiting fall, waiting fall to wall cling to waiting fall, waiting fall to waiting, waiting to climb. So why exactly are we going to waiting fall from the climb? Because I assume it's either this one or this one. So let's move this over to the side. Oop. Oh. I already got a bite. Okay, so we don't have a ground. That makes sense. Hmm. Oh, but now we do have a ground. Okay. Okay, hang on. Let's go to ground here, because I can't find it. Collider, that's fine. What's the normal here? It's basically up. So why are we... why is this bad? Because we have a ground and we have normal, and we are holding crouch, I'm pretty sure, unless it just didn't work right. This doesn't seem like an issue with specifically the water. But I don't know where else I can test it. Maybe here? So it seems like specifically overhangs, where I'm crouching. Oh, maybe it's because I'm on the ground still? Hmm. Something I especially don't like. Hang on. I'll figure it out later. Yeah, so I'm thinking this is another bug. Or just something else that I have to think about. So I'll say, let's just complete that. Let's fix this another day. Water, or crouching, no, climbing into an overhang while in the water causes a loop. Actually, I just realized what it probably is. Probably collider issues. Because when you're in water, your collider doesn't shrink. So basically, I've talked about before. When you're crouching, you use a different collider. So instead of this standing collider, it uses one of these. This itty-bitty one. It uses this itty-bitty crouching collider. So when you're in water, but you're holding the crouch button, you still have the big collider. But then once you actually start climbing, you have the little collider. How do I solve that? I just need to rework how the colliders work with climbing, because I was already talking about before, I didn't like it very much how the collider got so small when you climbed, because then it made it like wall clings and stuff feel wrong, or not generous enough. So what I'll say is, too small. And it should have a smooth transition from one state to the other. Because I was also having issues where when you jumped, you would then slam your head in a really weird way. But okay. That's enough of that. Now we need to do the, I'm gonna tee up an event. So let's do like... let's just have that. Global tee medium event. Orstad war. Well, yeah, I think it'll just be called that. I think each character will have their own event. (Clears throat) Maybe it should be called some... Well, let's call it prepare. So we'll just have function. Where do we have the medium stuff as well? Function prepare, medium, event, ID string, and then we will do a, what we'll just do is global, or no, set that medium event ID. And there'll only be one, I guess it'll only have the most recent thing as your event, because I was thinking about this as well. Like, if you talk to Orstad and you hear about the war, and then you have an event, what if you talk to another character and they tell you something, and then there's another event? And I've realized I don't think it would make sense for there to be one event after the other in that case, because I imagine the player's only going to talk to the medium like every once in a while. Like, it's not going to be like every minute or so they come back. So they'll have lost the context for like the previous event, regardless of which one it is. So regardless of if I do it in like first in, first out, or last in, first out. So what I'll just do is just, if you don't go to the medium, you miss it. So I might have some sort of, in fact, I just might have that here. Because where do I do stat, like signals? Or where is that in the UI? I know. I'll just have signal medium event ready. Well, I won't do that for now. Basically, I was going to say maybe there's a little UI indicator that shows up, but that would mean that I've already specifically said, once you hear the anecdote, you only get the full context if you then go with him to the city and see more of it and like learn about her personal life or learn about her early life and stuff like that. So if the player sees a little UI indicator and then beelines back to the medium, instead of doing this quest, they'll have an inferior experience. So instead I need some sort of like, I need that indicator when the optimal time to visit the medium is. So I'll put that in here somewhere. Let's just put that in medium events. So like ability to signal, adding events, completing events, and then like indicating when an event ready at the ideal time to see it, or like UI indicator. You know, because the video game should tell you when it's a good time to do something. But okay, and then what I can do is prepare medium event, and then we'll do function complete medium event, and we don't even need a thing there, so it'll be just set or remove stat medium events. Perfect. So let's make a little placeholder for this right now, because that'll count as our conversation. Oh yeah, I should also, where's PowerShell? I should commit what I've done so far. let's say, fix some water bugs. Alright, and then fixed some. Alright. And then for the rest of this, there we go. Alright, so let's go to the medium. Minor spoilers, because there is endgame content in the medium dialogue here, but hopefully it'll be incomprehensible to human eyes. Alright, so what we need now... How do we go to Primordial? Let's do, like, event, so dollar, event. Where should this be? Because we have these layers. This is a, I guess, the layer for that. Okay, so this is our first time activating the medium. So I think the event would be this one. And I don't, well... I think that's fine. Okay. Let's just do this. So basically, if event, go to event. Oh, and this should be that. Nope, this. So this creates this variable event, and then... What the heck is Hasvar here? Okay, whatever. If we have an event, we go to the event. Otherwise, we don't go to the event. And that'll just be in both places. And then we can create, so when we have Orstad, we have Orstad War, and that is going to do whatever it does. So we have the introduction, we have this, we have that, the other, and okay. So let's now start making the charade. So don't these zones have, like, doesn't this one have a specific thing? Oh, these need, like, visiting zones, I think. Yeah, it should extend this visit area. There we go. Because now we can have Iran. And custom stat none, I guess. Note, I guess. That seems fine. And then what we can do is if has Vadi visit stat, and let's do, well, maybe I should have it the exact opposite way. Hang on, I think I'll do that. Instead, maybe I need this to extend the zone. So this now extends a zone. And that way, I can just make this one specifically a visit area. But it'll still have the same priority. And I can also then put it in mask 2, so this way the player also collides with it. So place ID is, and then okay. So now let's go to stone. Let's do oh wait, this is what we need. So eventually we'll do like not stats visited slash Gerard. Otherwise, like main speaker, activate stone, and this will be to do other stone area, and also not stat. So like otherwise. So this will be like apartment. So that means for all of these Sharon homes, these would also be visit areas rather than other things. So 10 place ID Sharon home. And then I think we don't need a note. In fact, we probably don't need a note for Sherrod itself, but we'll have it anyway. Actually, what were the other ones that I wanted for that? Did I remember to actually... What are all of these things? Alright, that was me brainstorming. This was also me brainstorming. What is this? An empty file. What is this? That's the old file, okay. Let's also go back to this event. So what were the rooms that I had? Generic, blah, apartment, tree center. I think the tree center will be too ambitious for now, because I don't have any system for making rooms that are larger than the exterior of the building. Yeah, so let's, I didn't even put it here. Shroud apartment. Rod City Center with a standing tree, and this will be lower priority once I have the tech. Because I do think it'd be really cool to have, like, the room expand physically in physically impossible ways, but also quite difficult. Because then I'd need a bunch of, like, stencil stuff and, like, different lighting layers and things. Okay, that seems good. So stats, visited, / rod, home. To do basic garage walls. And then what is, oh yeah. Let's do okay. Would she say? I guess she would. Let's try. Because now I need to restart the game from the intro. Talk to Orstad, because then that's how we queue up the event. And then I can teleport back to the medium and see if this actually does what it's supposed to do. So let's do load game post intro. Then teleport. Terrain City 1. And then hello, buddy. There we go. I'm gonna unplug this dang tablet. It's getting in the way. Or maybe I'll just move it somewhere, move it over here. Oh, video game is. Hang on. There we go. And you know what? I was down on these little things before. I did not realize there were. Hang on. Let's just put that in the bugs. That counts as a bug. Huts should have more underground stuff. This album is a lot. I like it. I might skip this last song because, well, I'll think on it. Okay, what I need to do though is we need to go to here. Oh, video game don't work. Hang on, video game has malfunctioned. So this stuff, right? Because I need the stone room to be hidden. By default. That is horrible, Jackie. How did this even happen? Like, how did it happen again that this broke? How did that? Hang on. Where is the chair reference? Chair. Teleports. Is it not here? Player. Oh, it's set visual position to position, and then... Basis equals position dot basis dot rotate vector 3 dot up. How does it not happen? That's not correct. How does it not work? Hang on. Let's see if I can get this working. So I'm gonna have it on the other screen. But it's like, I literally didn't touch this code since the last time I playtested for the devlog. I sat in this thing for the devlog, I'm pretty sure. How does this keep fucking happening? This is like the fourth time this exact bug has happened without me changing this code. I think there should be a different version of this room for the, yeah, I'll make a different version of this for the quest or whatever. Generic red brick room in war. Oh, because this is the end dialogue. Set visual. But this is incorrect. So let's do like var g equals this. Try this again. Okay, so the player is positioned correctly. The camera is not, though, because I want to fix that, though. Okay, and also, Orstad should not be in here. Why are you in here? Wait, actually, literally... Oh, right, because he has the quest stuff. I think it would be best if there were some sort of dulling zone. So like some sort of no-go. So yeah, let's do that. Well, no. I'll just put that in the bugs as a thing to do. Add a no-go zone to the followers so they don't barge into the media. Great. Okay, because we need to focus on the conversation. Like, what exactly are we going to be learning here? Oh, wait, this was the... I wanted to do the other album from the same artist. There's a very cool introduction to this album by Toshiyuki Honda. This is September. I was just really struck by this intro, but okay. This is the perfect music to write a child in a war whose parents were killed. Oh, wait. Okay. What would happen? Don't I do something with this where I block special dialogue? No, I guess I don't. Right, we need to do that actually. Oh wait, actually, we shouldn't mention anything here, because this is what actually allows for using special notes, I think. I need to figure this out. Okay, so it's a global set and then blah. Okay, yeah, so we don't, so we should not have that there. What exactly do I want to accomplish with this? I think the funky beats are going to detract from my writing abilities here. But I'll think about it. Because what are some things? Like, war is scary. I guess it'd be useful to show that in a first-hand way. I don't know if I can actually muster the writing chops to make that specific feeling. Cuz how does a teenager feel in a city under siege, like in a city that is in an active war zone? Like, that's not really something that I can just draw from personal experience on. But I think that is the most important thing here. And I think it would be the most useful, like, I think it would be the most worthwhile thing to explore here, of just, like, making the player feel a secondhand version of the fear that someone would feel in a war zone like this. But I don't have the chops to write it. So I think I need to do some research on this, or write this off stream. But let's just say war is scary. A child in a war zone. Jackie tries to comfort her. Very grim. Comfort the child. Because now I'm thinking, like, if Jackie's trying to comfort Tara. Well, Tara's 15 here. So she's not, like, a very small child. Let's also have a special, like, leaving thing here. So let's do, like, mentioned forced on war. Let's do, like, go to exit war event. So how do we do exiting? Oh right, we already do this. So I think I actually have this. Exit where mentioned forced on war. And then let's do, like, this stuff. So we know, actually, we know all of this stuff is true, but. So events, exit, war start, no, exit war event. So we know that's good. That's good. Boom. Okay, so basically, what I think she would do when she leaves, I don't think Jackie really has the emotional capacity to, like, say goodbye properly, so she'd just leave. She would just get up off the chair and the medium would deactivate. Because I think this might be... That's actually a good point. Jackie's not really the type of person who, like, comforts other people. Especially not, like, kids and teens. So let's see if this war stuff works, if this exiting stuff is good. Oh yeah, and I also need to complete the event. Because now, every time we go back, it'll be done. But that's convenient for me for now, for testing. So let's have, like, we'll save war event. And then I can go into here and we can have a global complete medium event. Is that what I did? Yeah. Complete medium event. All right, that bug's gonna kill me. Okay. Okay, and this bothers me as well. The fact that I don't get why that happened. I don't get why the players rotated like this. Okay, let's fix this though. So G equals blah. Oh, we already have this. Oh, and we don't need this anymore, because we just have the exit anim. And in fact, does a player even need to have this here? Because now it's synced up. Oh wait, no. It is, it has to be there. Okay. That's all A-okay. And actually, I want to figure out. So what if I put the player down ever so slightly? Like, or move this chair down ever so slightly? Because where is it actually? Like, because it drives me crazy. And do we have like an activator? Okay, I see here, I think. Chair's too high up off the ground. Yeah, what if I just put it down like this? And then I could move that little band up. And also, I need to rethink this chair, because I need to rethink the medium visually as well. But okay. Now the chair is ever so slightly lower, which means that I assume Jackie's feet will touch the ground. And also, Jackie will not... she still janks out when she's there. And also... jank there, but I'll accept that for now. We love jank. Okay, how low can I put this thing before it actually becomes an issue? Still not good. Okay. How? What if I put it even lower? What if I just put it explicitly like through the entire floor so that it's very obvious that her feet are clipping? Will this work? No. Okay. It's like that is. Let's assume that's probably going to be fine. I'm gonna say I'll leave this as a placeholder for now, because I'd rather get, I think on stream it would be easier for me to do the other stuff. So we have to make versions of her. I guess I could just first off use the model of her. So let's go to stone. Well, let's make the rooms first. How do I want to do that? Maybe I need to get the stone room and I need to get a different version of it. Because I could just use this room. Well, what do I actually want the player to see when they're in here? Because I don't have a lot to work with. That was the wrong thing. Take your time, Krita. Let's try. Whereas the generic red room, it would be like this orangish color somewhere here, I guess. Why does it lock? Why does it lock the background layer? Why do I need a locked? Hang on. I want to. While we're here, Krita, background locked by default. Can I change that? Do I have to set? Whatever. I'm procrastinating. Because, okay, the real thing is, for a simple mock-up, you know, this much of the screen is being used by the dialogue thing. And then, like, 30% of the screen is being used by the player. Let's get, like, this in here. And then we got our cool, cool gray or green lighting. So it'd be like. This, very cool. Very spooky. And then what do we want for the actual, like, thing here? I'm still bothered by the fact that apparently the reason that Krita has the background layers is because they don't want people to mistakenly draw on it, but it's like, then just... I want to change the background by default. I don't want to have to just unlock a bunch of stuff. Okay, what am I thinking here? Because we're basically confined to a little box. What if we had, so we could have the same thing that we usually have, where there's a little wall here. And then, let's grab this now. So there's some sort of like, stuff going on outside. And this place is coming down. I don't know if this is even related to what I'm going to be doing. Because I think the real question is, how do I make this framing more interesting? If this is the default framing for this event. I guess I could move Jackie even further to the left. So what if we did like this? Jackie's mostly in the center of the screen still. And then instead of in front of us, this is going to be actually the exact opposite. So what I'm thinking is, because it's not really secure for her to be, like, I'm thinking of this in terms of, like, she has taken shelter inside of some sort of building, because this basically is before she gets shot in Orstad's anecdote. So they're basically waiting for soldiers to come in. Let's not have that. And so basically what I'm thinking is, we have a little form right in here. And I think maybe Jackie could be where she is normally. So this at least gives me a thing. What if Jackie is projecting a shadow? Or, more specifically, there's red light coming from behind us, and it's like... Wait, let's do soft light. Wow, this layer looks like garbage. Hang on. Let's do just a multiply, actually. Instead of doing what I was gonna do, we'll have it be this by default. And also Jackie should be in here then. And then we have the medium erasing away. No. Adding something like this. Maybe not like a poop brown, but you know, something other than that. Okay, hang on. Select opaque. Invert selection. Maybe just gray shadows here. This doesn't... That's not quite what I want. Oh, it's because it's not in the multiply layer. I'm thinking probably less aggressively red. But yeah, something like this. Okay, I can at least start making the scene with this. So I think what I'll do... Do I want all of these rooms to be in here overlapping? That's what I'll do for now. So this will be, war room red. And it will not have, well... Let's just make a room. So what are the dimensions of this thing again? Can I get like the bounding box on this? I don't think I can. Okay. Open recent, Wait, actually, I think I do have the primordial room. I think is just a cube. Yeah, 5, 3.28. And I think that actually translates to 10 by 6.4 by 16. Wow, I took a long time for that. Okay. Miss Z. Five. SY 8. So this should align. I guess that's fine. Okay, so for this one, it'll be like the other one, except there'll be maybe windows that are covered. And also, let's bevel this. Take your time, Blender. Jeez Louise. Take your time, Blender. Jeez. And maybe even just for some little, a little bit of force perspective. What the? Okay. Blender is not a program to use if you accidentally fumble keys literally ever. But alright. I'm not mad. Let's do this with button on this. And then what should I have in here? I think it should probably be... Well... What if it's just this? And then maybe we'll have... We could have, like... some fake doors here. Is this? There we go. Do I want this, or do I want just, like... I'm thinking, actually, let's get rid of this. Well... I'll keep that for now. So I think both this and this will have two separate materials. Let's do like a... these two. Or... No, I think that's not quite right. So this is going to be room, and then this will be the door, very high quality door. Actually, I think I might do... like a proper frame for this door. Let's do like a little sphere. What I'm thinking is that these are gonna be what I was talking about before, just the mix of modern and like old stuff. Wait, I don't need that. I can just zoom in like this or scale this down. So yeah, like a modern-ish, or a relatively modern-looking door and frame, but an old stone building. And probably the same thing with this one, actually. So let's bring this inward. So we'll do like just a simple cube. Oh, wait, no. There we go. And I think maybe I'll have some sort of like cracks in the wall up here, maybe? Or like some evidence of something going awry. How do I want to do that? I don't think I'll do that for now. No, that's not right. I'll keep that as it is, because basically I want the window to not cast shadows. Oh wait, I just realized I can just make the whole window not cast shadows. I don't need to worry about this stuff. Because then we can have the frame. Actually, I have a much better idea. Grab this whole thing. In fact, we don't even need these anymore, but I'll keep, well. Oh wait, no, we do need those. Yeah, because we need the window to be in here. Okay. So this part will not cast shadows and it'll have a different material. So this is like the window glass and then window frame. And then the door. And then the doorknob. And eventually all of these will have their own fancy little things, but for now they're just going to be part of this room. And I might even use this. Well, no, I wouldn't use the same room. Okay, and I should probably then make this style consistent. But okay. This is part of the medium. And then we do four room one red. And then I guess we could also have some interesting things with the like structure of the room. Like, we could have a bit more, like, deformation and stuff like this. Like, just pulling stuff around a little bit to, like, make it look a little more stone-like. Or, like, imprecise and made for people. No, made in, like, using not sophisticated technology. Actually, none of these... Oh, I was going to say, none of these need to be here, but then I remembered they do need to be here. Okay, never mind. Okay, let's export this. How do I make a light that casts shadows that doesn't affect the player? I'll have to figure that out. But anyway, let's go to... Where the hell am I going? Export. I forgot for like a while there what I was actually doing. Okay, medium, war room red. We only need... I always click the wrong thing. It's data material placeholder. Okay, let's do war room red. And then for now, what I'm going to do is... Brick. And then... dry planer. Because this has the color here, and then I can do noise. Oh wait, no, this is the wrong one. I was gonna do this on the doorknob, but oh well. Because eventually it's gonna be like... Let's do like a gray, actually. Honestly, this is not a very fancy material. Now that I've looked at this, nothing special. Okay, let's do like a wood. That's not gonna do it. Then here, let's do like 5, 5, and 5. Oh, right. Entities medium. Where do I put this? Like, where's the stone room saved to? Okay, entities environment medium. Let's hide this. Okay, so this was wrong. I see, because I needed to do this. Not quite. This. There we go. Right, because I had some sort of brain malfunction there. Okay, so let's make this one. What's in the stone room? So it'll be something similar to this. And then let's make this unique. And we'll have like a like spooky dusty red. All right, so now all we need. Let's go back to the stone room and figure out how the lighting works here. I think the big thing was, oh yeah, the big thing was all of these have to be in the same rendering layer. 17. And then the light itself. I want this to cast a shadow. And then I want the glass to not cast a shadow. And then, oh right, this wall should then cast a double-sided shadow, which unfortunately means that I can't do that. But okay, I think that does that. So I'm still, well, I guess I'll keep it this as it is. I don't think the casted shadows will work very well. Let's do like light, let's do like a low bounce light. Or like, no, just a red color. I'm getting confused as to what I want. Yeah, we'll blast it. Red light right on her. Then we'll do some cool, like, bounce light fake effect. By just having some subtle lower red lights. Might have, like, 0.2 energy or whatever. Let's have like 2 energy. Let's have it be like kind of harsh and weird. Okay, so now we have that, and then we can go to the illusory room. We can see how this looks in action. Just plop it in the old thing. Eventually I'll need a more graceful solution for this, but I'm not going to do it for now. Oh, right. I see. Oh, wait. So I think this needs to be here. Oh, it's twice as big as it's supposed to be. I think it was. Hang on, let's double check with, that's not what I want. This is what I want. First off, let's make this about cohesive with what it was. Yeah, I think this is, yeah, it's just twice as big. Okay, let's close this. Oh, right. Stone room, goodbye. Oh, right, we need to go to the war room again. Because now all of our lighting is messed up. The best laid plans of mice and men. And I suppose this makes it... Well, what does this do actually for us? I'm trying to spin this as a positive thing. Ah, well. It's just positioning some lights. So yeah, that looks good enough. Let's put this spooky red light in here. Just gives a little bit extra... Yeah. Because then that just further emphasizes this bounce light here. And then I would also like, I think, some negative lights. So if I did this, well, maybe like how is this? Don't these shaders all have the same, like, negative light thing? Where they're not supposed to, like, act all weird like this? Because I guess I could just add it, like, here. See what I'm going for? However, the issue is, it doesn't seem to behave right. Well, I guess it must be this light here that's causing it to act weirdly. Oh well. I guess what I could do, push this over a little bit, rotate it a little bit, then it's a little bit better. Still kind of weird. Let's just make it a little bit more subtle then. Because these things only affect a very limited set of things, so I can just go kind of wild with the lights here. Let's do like a raw. Do like 1.4 and then like 1. No, I don't like that very much. Well, yeah, I don't like that. That's okay. And for now, we'll add a cool little guy. Oh wait, so it's way more dramatic in here. Well, that's okay. And this is our cool little guy. Where the fuck are they? Just place the damn thing in the thing. Oh well. So yeah, they're gonna be in the corner, in the light, perfectly framed, as I definitely meant by the seat that I definitely knew was still. Wait, no. Hang on. These are supposed to do that. There we go. Okay. There we go. So I think maybe I should just duplicate this. Oh. What if I just add it to both of these layers? Well, no, because then the issue is I want it to be sort of weird and uncanny where, like, there's dramatic lighting for everything except the, like, light. What exactly do I want? Well, what I'm going to say is they're probably going to have some furniture pushed up against the wall. That actually makes a lot of sense. Okay. Let's go to the war room red. Let's figure out what furniture do we have. Because I've forgotten. Because we have these, but these are only after you only unlock the bed frame tech. God, I hate how I can't place things just in the room by dragging and dropping them. I have to, like, do a billion things. Okay. What does a Valor chair look like? Oh, that's a funky little thing. Yeah, no, we don't have those. Where the heck is Shelf Simple? Yeah, we can have one of these. So it's like they've barricaded the doors. And then, what else do we have? A little table? One of our little funny tables? These are like 5,000 feet. Hang on, I need to check the scale of this room now. I think the door is too small. Actually, I know the door is too small, so let's just... Because the door was actually designed properly. Origin to, no, center of mass. Well, yeah, that seems much more reasonable. So now the window is quite low as well. Do I want to bother with that? I'll bother with it. I'll have to reposition the lights again, but that's not that. Alright, so we do need these. Be like this, because this is driving me crazy. There we go. Because now I can actually move this appropriately. Okay, now this room will make more sense. Because we don't have itty bitty baby door. I guess, do we have the little stove things? Because realistically, or if I were going really thoroughly, I would only pick furniture that the player has seen in the game. But that's too much. I could do that, if I had more time. But I don't want to make more time. And admittedly, the amount of time I have is as much time as I want to dedicate to the game. Which means, I won't. Okay, because I swear I have a stove. I do, look at that. And we have a little, like, walk or something. Of course, let's get this peeking through the window to spook our poor kid. What can I put to cast a shadow right here? Why is this in city? That's weird. Well, I don't know. Oh wait, I also need to make these. Right, I need to make all of these. Man, I have a better idea. Let's go to the illusory room. And what we're gonna do is, when we get our geometry stuff, what is this? Hologram. Okay. When we do the hologram, we're also gonna do setting the layer properly. So like const layer equals 1 shifted to 17, I think. Yeah. Oh wait, no. Because we start at layer 1. Let's do if node is visual instance layers equals layer if node is light dot light layer. So this way, it'll automatically do the correct thing. And then we can have this. There we go. So that way I don't have to constantly make all of these, like manually do that for every single thing here. Okay, now let's go to the illusory room. You see our scared little guy. Let's see how this feels in-game. As soon as I figure out how to do that. So activate mode equals default. R equals mode. Rooms. Couldn't I just do... Hang on. I have a much better idea. Spatial rooms And I'll just have a special case, so like, if r equals default. Do I even use the default? Oh well, whatever. Hologram. True. Else. False. And, so. Rooms. Get node mode dot visible. True. Alright, let's do like. On ready var rooms equals rooms. So we're going to rename all these. So it's going to be just stone, primordial, war room red. In fact, I'll even put them in order. Okay, so. For r in rooms dot get children r dot hide if mode is default we'll do hologram dot visible equals true otherwise we'll hide it and we'll get a room in the node and then we'll do this. And then that should all be good. That should be off. And then we can copy this, paste this. Okay, so now we don't even need these. So now what I can do is we can do, instead of stone room red, we'll do war room red. Okay, let's see how this goes. Because now we have our cool little spooky room. I mean, it looks like the room exists, but this isn't quite right. Okay, let's do. Ah, we didn't do this. Get children. And then we can load up whatever it was, the war event, I think I called the save. Okay, so that works, except the ceiling's a little too tall. And the door feels a little too tall as well. Well, it looks like it's the right room. Okay, and then let's do just, you know what? What if we just did rooms.hide and hologram.hide? Hang on, and let's do activate rooms. Hide, and then rooms.show. And then node.show. Do we need this rooms visible? I guess we do. Oh wait, no, that's not quite right. Okay, let's see if I can get the functional. Because I don't think I've actually completed the event yet. Actually, that's kind of weird as well. Okay, and I know why that jank is there. That is because... Oh, wait. Let's go to... Print. So let's copy the stone material from this room, because it uses, I think, the local vertex coordinates. Yeah. And that's for a reason. Because otherwise, the... this triplanar. Let's get the metal. And so these are all local, epic, good. Oh wait, and this one's not gonna be local though. Well, what if I just make it local? It's like we could just do. I'm like. Beautiful. Alright, and also, we had to slightly lower the roof of the thing in the back. And probably shrink the door a little bit. It just feels larger than it's supposed to be. Cause like, all right, where's the cursor? So down here we're at negative point, or no, we're at negative 0.09. Up here, 2.2. So that's only 2.3 meters. So that's not especially tall for a door, I don't think. Yeah, it could be a smidge shorter, I guess. Let's do like that. Yeah, it just feels disproportionate. And then let's get this stuff. That thing still, let's see what I want to do with that. Hang on, let's go back to that shelf simple. So if things are going to be compatible with the, so this, let's make this unique and let's use just a actually let's just use copper local coordinates. Yeah, I'm not the boss of me. Okay, so I've started on the room. Oh wait, there's collision. Oh no. So I actually do need to make all of these, how do we do this? War Room Red. Let's just, yeah. So we need to make all of these editable. Specifically, just to remove the, or to make these static bodies just have zero. Ah, well. But now we can walk out it, walk in and out of the room. And ideally what I would have is a system to actually load these from separate files, but I'm not going to do that. Okay, so now what I want to do is fix that dang camera. Okay. Started on the medium event, Orstod's war and anecdotes. Room for war events. Nope. Okay, and I know that's good. So now what I need to do, I know exactly what that is as well. Let's go to camera rig. Set visual transform. And let's do reset camera false or equals true. Set camera. And then equals true. And then we'll do if reset camera. Oh, wait, no. This. And then this. And then what I can do is when we go to the illusory room, and when the player sits, we just don't reset the camera. Because it's basically from using this same visual reset for like teleporting and also this respawn. But okay, let's see if this fixes it. It should, because I just set it to do it, but you never know with writing code. Okay. So if I'm here, there we go. It does jitter a little bit, actually. So let's also do, let's move this to here as well. So that way the camera doesn't move positions. It still feels a little bit, well, I guess it's smooth. It just feels like it jumps a little too much. Northstar pops out. So what they should do is there should be like a stop following mode, where the characters just don't follow you into places. So yeah, the next things to do would be to make different versions of her, different animations for the character here. This turned out pretty well. Okay, So now let's make, let's commit this. Don't reset camera when sitting. So we've done a little bit of this work. Ooh, it's bright. Generic red brown, or generic red brick. And also dialogue, probably off screen. So what should I do next? I think I'll make a similar room for when we are in Sherrod. And so it was is something I see. So it's actually 3.2 meters tall, not 6.4. And then we do, hang on. Let's go back to this. How is the primordial room structured? Okay. And so these sizes are not the same sizes as the other things. Basically, we do 2.5. That was... SY4. There we go. So this is the bounds of the room that we have to work with. So this is specifically for when the player hasn't seen one of these apartments before. So what would they, what would Jackie assume about them? I'm gonna say she would assume that they have like things that go off in different directions maybe. I don't know what she'd assume exactly. I'm gonna say, let's put the player like in here with the feeling of like there's something beyond this place. And then I need to make sure that this actually doesn't exceed the bounds that we have for ourselves. So X is 5. This needs to be a little bit inward a little bit. Oh, what the heck? Oh, okay, I see. Do I not have any other music? Oh no, it just paused. I think I may keep it like this, even for both of them. Well, maybe not. Yeah, I'm thinking. You know, these actually help with me with brainstorming, like, the actual style for these. Because now I'm thinking, I want little windows. And then I'm going to do an auto smooth. And then, pardon the norms. So how do I... excuse me. How do I accomplish what I want here? Because basically what I want is to extrude this in effectively. But maybe it would be easier to fake that by doing this and then doing this. And also, these ones don't need this. Okay, so I think these two will be black. How do I... Blender. Wake up, Blender. There we go. It took a little bit too much out of it to figure that out. Okay, so there's gonna be like floors and stuff. And then this part is gonna be... I think that'll be as it is, actually. Because what I'll do instead is I'll have a cube here. And I'll do the same thing that I've been doing, where this will have an emissive texture to imply like an outer world. So now we have room, or room, charade. And then like glowing window. Yeah, this just straight up looks better than like the actual charade. But I guess that makes sense, like a tiny little room. Yeah, I won't. Oh. Okay, so now, war room, oh wait. Data, material. Wow, I got it in one. Yeah, and I might skip the apartment now that I'm looking at this. I think it just looks better. If I have the technology for the trees, that'd still be cool. Let's do try planar local for both. I think it'd be... Well, this one we don't need it. We can just do a new spatial material because this is going to be unshaded and just flat black. Oh, messed this one up. Yeah, actually, this is another one. Hang on. I'm just going to remove this material. Because I think this is another thing where it would make more sense to just have a cube here, because then I don't have to deal with the bevel. So this will now be called Oh wait, I can just use my shadow material as well. In fact, I don't even need, like, these. Okay, so let's just call these shadows. Oop, not quite. Scale, and let's have center of mass. Okay. Oh, wait. Okay, now I'll show what this is actually going to look like now. Let's do... Yeah, that's good. So, charade. We no longer need... that there. And let's go to death flame. There we go. And it actually needs, wait, I don't think this works correctly. So where's my water? I know my water shader actually does this. Position Y minus vertex position. Hang on, let's actually get into... Let's actually do it here. So where are materials? Because I need to look at two materials at once, which is more than Blender or Godot can do. Oh wait, no, let's... Whoops, I did the wrong thing. Oh well, if I really need those, I can go back to the footage and see what I forgot. But okay. So I need water first off. Water shader. And then I want death plane shader. I don't know where that's gonna be. Material. Okay, so it's just in the top level. Didn't I fix this? So where's our mix foam color? That's not quite right. Wait, I guess it is. Foam color... Maybe it's water with water with interior, or water interior maybe. Okay, I think this is what I need. Let's see if I can understand this. See, I think the death plane, it does not need a diff Y. It just needs the depth. So we're just gonna do F. No, that doesn't seem like it does what I want either. Oh, because it's 1 minus F. Let's try this. Okay, so that does kind of what we would want. But now, how do we get it to, I don't know what I don't know how to get it to do what I want it to do. Because I swear I did this before. I guess it is the world I guess we do need the world position. Oh, I'm realizing now. A much easier way of doing this would be to just do the length here. Maybe? That doesn't seem to work. Because this is our position. Let's try just doing, albedo equals, like, u position. Okay, so this, what if we did W position? Oh yeah, because that was the position in the screen. Okay, so now we're getting something that looks a little bit better. Because it's getting, yeah, because it's actually getting the position here. So then we could do position. And that gets the position of this on the plane, which looks right. So then Y is if Y so why is this not correct? Okay, this is correct. Oh wait, is it because now we need to do no, this seems correct. Oh wait, hang on. Am I doing this divided by zero? Max, let's do like max depth equals n. Okay, I think I was just dividing by zero. It actually works perfectly fine. Yeah. Because if I did, like, 0.5 here. Look at that. Well. I guess we gotta, I don't like how weird it is. Like, it changes based on the camera angle, which I don't care for. Oh, I guess, actually, now that I'm looking at it, or thinking about it, I guess it makes sense. It kinda has to. Because now it's doing, I guess I could do the normal. No, how would I figure out, how would I figure this out actually? Because basically the plane is actually like, this is correct because this position is much further than this position, like in 3D space. Like, because we gotta remember the plane is actually like this geometry. So how would we get the actual depth? Ah, well. I'll say it's good enough, probably. Well, I guess we could assume if it's a flat plane, how would we determine from a point behind the plane, the distance to the plane, like the closest distance? Because we do have our normal. And we have a position. Okay. I think I can figure this out. Let's get a distance to a plane. Distance to plane. Because we have our position P, so this. Which position is ours? Oh, this position is ours. And then we can do the normal. So we have our position, which is W position. And then our normal is this. And then our Q is this. Or our normal is the actual normal, and Q is position. Okay. That's fine. Unit normal vector. So the distance equals the length of a dot, or of the normal dot position plus d, whatever d is. But d equals this. Okay, let's try to get this. So distance equals. Oh. Is this just the thing? So it's the absolute value of the dot product of V dot N, where V is our position minus the other position. Oh, that makes complete sense. Length, position, so it's like position minus pixel position dot normal, and then we can ignore this stuff. Invalid member for vec3 expression dot. Oh, dot xyz. Oh wait, hang on. Oh, it's because we can't do. We gotta do length dot position minus pixel position normal. Dot xyz. Does it work? Hang on. B equals this. And then this is D. No. Yeah. No, I know. Oh, it's because I'm... We don't need the length anymore. We need the absolute value because the dot product is the length. Okay, and now it did not improve at all. But I could have sworn that'd be correct. Maybe it's something, well, what would it be, actually? So we're getting, so, like, we get a point behind us. So basically what this is supposed to do, if we look at it in 2D, like, let's say we have the plane here, and we have an object here. Basically, the problem is, if we look at it from this angle, this depth is further than if we looked at it straight on, but we want the same angle each time. So what I'm trying to do right now is, we can get this position minus this position to get this vector. And then if we dot that with the normal, we should get this vector. No, wait, we wouldn't get that vector. F3D equals this. And then we're going to do dot D times dot. Wait, that's not right either, is it? So yeah, this is doing now just an even worse version of what I was doing before. Is that? Why is that? Because basically it should just completely eliminate this perpendicular component of this vector. Maybe this W position dot XYZ? No, that's not right. It's right, because the we need the W component for... Do we need the W component? I have no idea how the W component works. Okay, clearly dividing by the W position is not the way to go. I feel like this is some problem with space at this point. Because let's do vector 3. Dist and 1. Yeah, because we're still seeing the same issue as before. Like, amounts. I mean, one weird thing is, why is it, like, getting less here? That's just wrong. That's just not even remotely correct. Is that because the dot... No, that doesn't make any sense. I was going to say because the dot is... this seems like an area where the dot is completely parallel to the normal. But why would that cause issues? Oh, wait, hang on. This is the screen space normal, not the world normal. What we need. Aha. Look at that. And now, when you look at it from this angle, you can see the fog going in, but you can see it this way as well. Beautiful. Okay. So now this works. Depth, color, RGB. And now, it's consistent. It doesn't change with the angle. And then we can change this to actually like be like a consistent. Let's do like 0.4 or something. Ta-da, now it's like, ooh, what's beyond the edges of our mysterious little world? Ooh, and look at that. Yeah, so it even works beyond the edges of the plane now. Okay, that's really cool. I like that. That worked perfectly. It did not take any amount of time whatsoever. Okay, let's do a triplanar. Oh wait, no. Local coordinates. Oh wait, will the shadow, will this thing mess up the shadows here? Or these? Yeah, I think these things might actually mess up because of the world vertex coordinates. I can figure that out. I can just make them use the, I can just call the matrix shader or whatever. Yeah, I'll figure that out. Okay, so we need, wait, we don't need that there. Okay. Let's go to monument. Yeah, let's do like one. Huh. Oh, okay. It is correct here. It just looked weirdly deformed. No, actually, I don't think this is correct. It looks, look at it. There's something wrong with color. Yeah, it's just something wrong. There's just something wrong with it. It's not quite what it's supposed to be. What is happening with this, though? And why have I never noticed it before? Because it seems to be specifically the YZ axis? Where would that be? Color X. So Z, negative Y, UV scale. So what if we did like, so just to make sure I'm in the right ballpark. Okay, so that is the, so this is the right part that's messing up here. Actually, I think it probably is something to do with the powers here. So let's do something with these. No. I do actually kind of like
the darkening here. It looks like fake ambient occlusion, but that's just a bug with my triplanar shader. Yeah, there's something wrong with my... I don't know what it is. Because, yeah, these bricks look normal. These do not. Okay, I do see, though... I think it's the normals themselves, actually, looking at this. So what if we didn't have the hardened normals? Yeah, let's try not having these, because this could look worse. Do I have any more music? What's happening? I think part of this is just muted. Yeah. If I... Oh wait, no. That's not gonna fix anything, because these are local triplanars. No, actually... And thinking about it, I'm certain that it's not an issue with the local, or with the triplanar shader, because we have the other rooms. So, like, these ones work perfectly fine with all four directions, so clearly it's something wrong with, however it is. So while we're here, so need that. Okay, so I'm going to try hardening the normals again. I know what it is. The scaling. So if we go into this room, transforms. Oh, there are no scales. I was so sure that'd be the right thing. Is there really no scaling on this? Looks like there is none. Huh. Cause like, okay, yeah. Cause yeah, the scaling doesn't help here. Hang on, let's get bricks in here. Okay, so this one's messed up too. In the exact same way, which makes sense. But then, hang on. Let's do... Let's make another material. So I'm thinking... Whoop. And then this will be, like, test... blend? Basically. Then we'll do test here. So if I did just a simple triplanar Select stone. No. Great. Okay, so this A-okay. Looking good. What if we then add a bevel modifier? And then we auto smooth. And we set this to go up to like that. I won't save that. Blend. Now, let's get this again. And let's do brick. And it's still A-okay. Oh wait, no it's not. Wait, kind of. I'm confused, the modifier doesn't seem like it's actually applying properly. Which actually, now that I'm looking at this, I don't think the modifier is applying here either. Okay. The modifier doesn't work. That's what it is. Oh, it's because I didn't save. Okay. And that's probably an issue with this war room then. So let's go to here. Oh no, that has that. So why didn't this have that? Why did it have it? So let's go to blend.glb, delete that. War room charade. Okay, there we go, at long last. So Blender, well, admittedly that's my fault because my plugin doesn't check the settings. Huh. So let's just add, what do we want to do with this? So I want to make this aesthetically cool as well. So all of these be in the same layer as before. New spatial. Unshaded, wherever that is, there we go. And this will be, I think, a yellowish red. This will be exactly as these are, and we'll also cast a shadow. And that means this. It's double-sided shadows, which is very convenient, very easy to use. So where do we actually, like, how do we get through this now? Oh wait, we can, by just disabling the shadows here. Oh wait, no. Off. This to be a little bit like this. How do we actually get light through here? Right, I should also check the scale of this place. Ah, well. I'll do... Let's have the spotlight do, like, a, bright peach-colored light, and then... Omni lights will do the same thing, and they'll be all configured properly. Now that I'm thinking about it, I don't want to bother with all that stuff. Or, setting the opacity or whatever. Or no, setting the cull mask, I should say. The script does that now, so I don't need to worry about it. So we'll do our fake little scattering here. Let's do like negative. There we go. Okay, let's go back to the illusory room. Let's put this with the war rooms. Very dramatic, very cool. There we go. I think this is probably where, so where do the other ones go? Oh, the carpet's just like a million feet off the ground. It's like 200 meters, 200... Yeah, it's just like 30 miles off the ground. Okay. These rooms don't work. Okay. Okay, so now I should also figure out how to make some of this stuff less janky. Because this spotlight seems incorrect. Look at this. We're positively gaming. Okay, so let's put a little NPC in here. So eventually I need to do something better with the design of these. Let's put it in here. So I'll be hiding out in here, and there'll be like, blood or bodies or whatever, something cool and twisted. But okay. Wait, and this needs to be invisible. We don't have the war room charade in here. So let's just do... For now, let's just do, like, war room charade. Okay, so let's see. It doesn't have the thing. So we need a hologram. Okay, here we go. So we haven't visited Sherrod yet, so we're gonna leave. So let's teleport to terrain. Sherrod. So now we have entered the city. Oh. And we have conveniently spawned back here, but that was deliberate. Okay, four room Sherrod, on call active. Okay, so it did work. Just need that. And I think the last thing I'll do then, today, will be making the complete event flag work, because for some reason that hasn't been working. Didn't quite work. Let's also slightly move this up, because I think it's clipping with the floor. Okay, that fixes that. And yeah, that doesn't quite work. So why doesn't it? Oh, because it doesn't have the materials. And it should have, well, that works. Copy. Paste. Admittedly, I should just have these, like, not in this janky setup, but, well. And now I can use these as basically false advertising for the game, since none of the other game, or none of the rest of the game, has any sort of bounce lighting, fake or not. Orstad is making this very awkward. Quite happy with how this has turned out. It's a nice little setup. Oh wait, I need to check the, I want to check how those look when they come in. Okay, the depth flags look like they work pretty well. Those were the only thing where I was worrying about flickering, but it seems like they just work somehow. Okay, so let's say that the modeling is done for now. So let's say this will be lower priority. Oh yeah, I should also have like more evidence of conflict in the rooms. So that'll be high priority, but later. And I think, yeah, these will be important. Or maybe some more defined way of having the thing filter. Oh yeah, and thanks for the chat. Or thanks for the positive comment in chat. Medium material dot material. Where's that even from? So do any of these have... There's like a Star Wars theme in here. Okay, what is this called? Okay, it's called Star Wars Samba. Because this is from an album by Masayoshi Takanaka. Here we go. Get this thing out of here. Okay, and then... cool, rooms for the medium. Because now we got more cool stuff. Okay, and next. Yeah. Let's see, so I don't need this anymore. So yeah, once I have more evidence of like things happening in here, I like decals. And honestly, this looks so much better than the actual thing. I wish I had baked lighting still. Or, actually, an alternative that I could try is painting the vertices of the, painting an ambient occlusion into the vertex colors and then using that in the shader. Because that could also work with these and, like, augment this further. But okay. I'm gonna say... got a promising start on this, though admittedly I did skip the hard part of actually writing the dialogue there. But I'll do that this Saturday. But I'll be back Sunday for more exciting stuff with the medium, probably, since I got a month left to go to make this the best it can be. But okay, see you later.